Hello, everyone, and welcome back. We're back again. Storm here.
Mom here.
Kimmy here.
Hi, guys.
Hi.
So we're going to be watching more of The Clone Wars today. This has nothing to do with The Clone Wars. This is Avatar The Last Airbender. I won't say whose mask it is, but it is called the Blue Spirit. And it made me think of Savage and Darth Maul. Because we're watching episode 21 of season 4. This one's called Brothers. The thumbnail gave it away. That's my point. So sometimes there's spoilers and we're not reading the description because, again, we've been spoiled in the past slightly for certain episodes. But we see Savage, and even on episode 22, we see Darth Maul. So I am guessing we're going to see them meet up.
Yes.
Finally,
we get to see this.
Long time coming, for sure.
Yeah, big time.
Right. So we were really excited about that. I think it was earlier on this season. It wasn't too long ago, but we watch two episodes a week, so a lot of time does pass since we saw that episode. And I like following Ventress. That was fun, the last few episodes.
And I do too.
I mean, it was tragic. It was absolutely terrible. All those people lost in that big battle.
Massacre, yeah.
I mean, losing all of her sisters, losing everything that she knew and she went back to.
And like, Mother, too.
Yeah, and right. I'm in denial. I'm always in denial. I liked Mother, and there was so much mystery with her and the magic. And I like to quote things because I know it's like the Force, and she manipulates it to make it like dark magic. I feel like maybe she can use the Force kind of like a Jedi or something.
Yeah.
And she's not really dead, but she might be around.
Oh,
yeah, like her spirit might be around to help guide Ventress down the road. I don't know. But I thought she was a really cool character, so I hope that wasn't the end of her. And last episode was awesome because of Boba Fett. We love following him. We love the Mandalorian, and that was great. With that, I'll just say I'm sure you guys know that. And seeing Boba Fett, you guys were saying that lizard, I feel bad, I don't remember names, but he...
We just don't remember when we saw him.
Yeah, we saw him when he was doing that other job with Aura Sing. You know, way back when.
Oh, okay, yes.
The Atena girl, like, she was an awesome person, Atena I kept, like, calling out because it was just funny.
Yes.
But I really liked her character as well. So I love how they bring characters back because Star Wars, like, the creators, they're just absolutely amazing to always have a purpose and remember all these side characters that may not mean anything in certain cartoons, but no, they come back and they all have huge histories, even if we've only seen them a couple times. So this lizard guy was like with Boba Fett and trust him and was just with him the whole time. I mean, they got back together because, you know, they went their separate ways or whatever and ended up, you know, back where Ventress saw them. But that was cool that they all worked together on that mission.
And I like it. He's kind of eerie too, you know, with that slithering.
I love that too. And I joked last time because when he did that hissing, like, it seems very aggressive, which I'm sure it probably was, but we don't understand that culture or the species. And it's amazing how we can interpret something completely different, even just in a different country.
When he's probably just breathing.
Yeah, because it might just be breathing or something. Or like snakes and stuff, they use their tongues to sense people and to smell people, right? So that just might be a normal action to communicate with people. And again, that's like overthinking things, but I love how diverse this universe or galaxy is, where you have all kinds of different species. It really just opens your mind to the possibilities, you know.
Right.
And it's so easy to misunderstand communication.
And even on that line, even the universes, the different planets we go to, I mean, some are subterranean.
I love that.
That's right.
The underworld thing that we did a while ago. That was great.
Right.
And how the Jedi, like, they always help out in all kinds of terrain. So we always see aquatic characters on land with the humans or human type creatures, you know, fighting. But when it comes to the human people or human-like people to be underwater, they can do the same thing. So it's great that it isn't always strict just to land, because most humanoid type creatures are land animals, you know. So it's kind of fun to see that because, again, we see a lot of aquatic creatures helping on land more than humanoid creatures helping in water. So I like seeing that switch up to be like, no, they're going to help too. They're going to equally help as well. It's not like, well, you're on your own because you're underwater. We can't do much there.
That's right.
They find ways. And I know people will honestly debate that as well because they're in spaceships. They're always out in deep space and it's kind of like water in a way because you have a lot of heavy pressure all around you. And so they have the technologies, but still fighting in that environment is just very different. So anywho, we can just tangent about that all day. I love it. So shall we get into this and see Sauvage?
Yes.
I know this isn't Sauvage, but
let's do it.
Let's do it.
Do it.
And I do have my dark saber.
Thank God.
It's ready to go. 421. Ooh, it's red. That blew my mind. A fallen enemy may rise again, but the reconciled one is truly vanquished.
Sauvage oppress. Beaten and alone, he returned to Mother Talzin, who gave him a new quest to pursue his long-lost brother.
Sauvage oppress is growing stronger. Something is rising. Something sinister.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Oh, that's terrible.
You didn't like the coffee? Oh,
this dust. It's a clue.
Huh.
You are getting closer and closer. I must make the necessary preparations.
I wonder if this is like a flashback.
This fire has got to be.
Yeah. What's with the dust? I love the music. So that keeps glowing every time the dust is on it.
The cargo you just dropped off. What planet did it come from?
The junk fields on planet Lothar Minor.
Take me there.
Hopefully you'll survive.
Oh, wow.
Welcome to Dot Steiner.
We're only trying to help. You want to tell me what happened here?
We have it under control, sir. It looks like only a simple altercation. Happens here all the time.
He's telling the truth.
You're not going to kill me, are you?
Until after you give it to the planet.
I sense a disturbance. Something sinister.
All the way out here?
It feels familiar.
Darth Maul.
I guess things could be worse.
Stab!
See, well,
that's how.
I wouldn't want the guy behind me.
Get out now!
Oh, you're dead.
I'm here at last, brother.
That sucked.
That's ridiculous.
No,
take the animal.
When I'm so close.
Go back. Maybe you just went a little too far.
Yeah.
Hey, big guy.
I don't have time for you.
I could help you. I can get you what you want. Payment, free pleasure. What you need is a guide.
Leave me alone.
He has a bigger purpose, because he almost killed you.
Not everything on this planet is junk. You're already heading in the right direction. You'll need my guidance to avoid the fire breathers.
Ooh, dragons?
Oh, whoa.
Oh, cool.
Oh, wow.
I really like the animation in this one, too.
Yeah.
Junkers, strange folk. We better get out of here.
Robotic chalice.
Robotic
chalice.
Yeah, I kind of like it.
Yeah.
wipes out everybody.
Wow.
Run.
Who are you looking for?
My brother.
Why is he so interested?
I'm searching for him.
Oh, I just heard stories about a horned man. They say he drags things down beneath, and they never come back up.
He has a bigger purpose, because why is he helping
him? Yes,
What a planet.
That goes down below.
Welcoming.
Oh, hanging out?
My God.
It's glowing again.
This is it.
We're all dead.
Mother Talzin. She betrayed me. My brother must be dead.
No. Something's gonna.
She's not the only one who betrayed you.
I knew there was something.
Oh, jeez.
A good evil left.
Ooh,
it's a spider. He's glowing a lot.
Touch the dust.
Yeah. It's mechanical.
Is that you, brother? You brother?
It's like leading him further and further in. Ooh, it's
ooh,
a body.
A live one.
What the heck?
Is that him on a spider? Oh, that is freaking creepy. Yeah, look at that. That's him, I think. Ew. How is that even possible? Ugh, he's in so much pain.
Ooh.
No. Yes, we are brothers. You don't know anything. Never.
What a life. Holy crap.
Ooh.
How do you fix that?
I'm ready for my leftovers.
Wrong timing.
Isn't that happening?
I found him this way. It wasn't me. I found him this way.
You're gonna die. Snap. Ooh, he snapped his neck. And in the fire.
Oops. Guess so.
Through victory, my strings have broken the chains. The chains are the easy part.
It's what goes on in here that's hard.
I am fear. Always remember, I am hunter.
I am nothing.
Wow.
Your legs.
Mercy is a lie, a delusion of the weak to think themselves strong. I ask not for mercy.
What is it?
I must have revenge.
Oh boy. Obi-Wan.
Wow.
Fear, you are in danger. I do. From the dead, an old enemy has awakened, killed your master many moons ago.
Darth Maul, alive?
It's gonna end there. The music, you gave it away.
Oh boy. No. Thank God I can feel it.
How creepy.
Oh, that was creepy, creepy. Ooh.
That was crazy. That was a good episode, too.
Wasn't it?
Yeah. So it just had Savage and that worm guy, and then we saw Darth Maul. So we were talking about it before, because we know in Solo that, spoiler alert, he comes back, and that was mentioned by a few of our fans. So we really appreciate what you guys have to say, of course, but we knew he came back, but we never saw how he came back. And we knew he was cut in half, but how does he get his body back together? So this is weird and cool in how they did it, because I just expected him to be a whole body again, his normal body underground.
Yeah. Right, and how did he acquire these legs? And
yeah, I so wish he's fused with this mechanical beast or something. Yeah, it's bizarre.
It's like spider-like.
Yeah, it's so freaking scary. Yeah, I love the design because it looks like, I mean, he has mental problems now too. He's all crazy. Yeah. And he looks like he's in a lot of pain as well because it's only his upper torso fused with this machine. So how bad is that? Like, torture, the years that he's been like that and eating live flesh, I guess, like a predator,
It's almost like he's blood sucking because he's not eating the bodies. He's keeping the bodies there. So just like spider, sucking the life out of him.
Gross.
Oh my, gross.
Gross. And it was creepy too, seeing skeletons down there, all kinds of like big beasts. We saw huge rib cages and over time, can you imagine how it smells down there? Just it has a lot of machine parts too, but I'm sure there's a lot of rot. So just to live underneath there for so long, and what a planet too. Dump planet.
Yes. It's nothing but just garbage.
That's right.
Burning stuff, like the chemicals you're breathing in, like it's just terrible acid rain.
Oh my God.
And that worm creature, we were kind of suspecting something was going on there, but the way it was talking, Savage almost snapped your neck, crushed your neck in, and you still wanted to help. Like, I get you want money for it, you want a price or something, but that makes you seem more legit that you're not looking for anything else. But the fact that he was almost killed, and he goes, I'll do it for free then. And he had so many chances to just slither away and not, just hide from Savage. And Savage would have just carried on because he didn't really care anyways. He wanted to do it himself. But... Mm-hmm. Yeah, so he kept going.
But you
for
were right.
It.
And he, he did have something a reason upstairs. Why he, he was.
Why would he do that?
Him.
Yeah.
So harsh environment. He wants to eat leftovers. I get that. But what a creature. So I know they come in all shapes and sizes. And I'm glad we discussed that in the beginning of the intro, where we're like, you have so many different species. Communication can be different for everyone. But to see a snake, a talking snake, it almost made me laugh at first. Right. I think I might have giggled a little bit at first. Cause I was like,
because he almost had a little personality, a little of Jar Jar. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's true.
Shere Khan.
Yeah.
I like his voice and everything. And you can't always go by shape and stuff because we don't know actually where their brain is located. Maybe it's a super long brain or something, but he has such a small head and a snake. So they don't have human size.
That's right. Yeah.
Yeah. Human sized brains to really have, to be able to speak and all. But it's fun. Yeah. I thought that was actually a really cool idea. And Savage is a very intimidating character.
Yeah, he sure is.
He is. He's very far. Barbaric at times. He just gets
he's checking
angry
that guy. We knew he was done for, but let's find a bad way for you to go. Let's just drop you from way high up in this burning sharp metal pile. Did he survive? I'm okay. If that didn't get you, the fire, the creatures, or the acid rain's gonna melt you up.
That's right.
Lovely planet. Wow. But it makes you think how much garbage is around. They probably take all kinds of garbage from all over the galaxy and drop it there or something.
Probably
have those means, right?
These creatures that are just, salvaging whatever they can to survive and sell. And I like the way he was just touching the dust and bringing it to the pendant and trying to look for his brother that way.
Yeah. I wonder why that had meaning, because the mother might have done something with her magic or something. But I'm thinking that maybe that's gross. I shouldn't be like that. But skin cells are dust, and maybe over time he just shed it a lot. He's really stressed out, so maybe he sheds skin kind of. I don't know.
Maybe or it takes someone else's.
Or just because of the planet or dust. Someone else's skin cells. Yeah. So I like how we had that pendant, and in a way, when he kept talking to Mother, and even though he probably doesn't know she died or whatever happened to her on her planet when she disappeared, I was thinking again, the Force, maybe she's still around, and she is in that pendant, or part of her is in that pendant, but I doubt it. I think it's just the magic she put in it to kind of hone in on Darth Maul's existence. So that whole idea was actually very interesting. And I love the outcome of Darth Maul, because that is so morbid and great for that character being so tortured. I'm not saying because he's such a terrible character. He did a lot of bad things in the prequels of Star Wars, but he was a really cool bad guy. But just him getting cut in half. I'm like, what's he going to look like right now? How is he living? But that's perfect. It's creepy. It's only
creepy,
a torso. He's really in a lot of pain.
It's really painful to be on his torso.
It's actually giving me chills, because I know he's going to be normal at some point. So maybe his lower half will be machine or something. because of Solo. Oh, he was just, we just saw,
or maybe independent. There's some kind of black magic that will make him have his whole body back. I don't know.
Maybe
that's why Mother wanted him to go there and deliver, so he can be whole again.
Yeah. So what's he gonna do? Maybe. Just rip off your body here and stick it on this, or take off a few more legs and just have now, because then he's gonna be all curled up.
And if it's back, if it's, you know, back in time where we're seeing this timeline where she was alive, when she was alive,
that's true too.
What's gonna happen to the pendant, like once, when it comes back to present?
Maybe he won't need it anymore since he found him. I don't know if it has any other purpose.
Yeah.
Or like where he's supposed to go from there, because maybe it'll keep guiding him after he found Darth Maul to do the next step or something. I don't know. But that is true. So I think that happened where we have these different stories going on, and we're watching in chronological order. But in this case, you know, we're in the present time, but that was just a flashback to what she was doing, and or, you know, was before she actually passed, before the massacre. It was taking place maybe around the same time or something. Who knows?
Yeah.
Interesting. Yeah. Now, I like this planet. We never want to go and vacation there or go even visit it. But I love the animation behind it. I have to geek out about that, because we were following one character. We have the snake-like character. Cool. We didn't have a whole bunch of characters in this one. But then those, like, junkers or whatever, they were kind of cool. And then the fire breathers. I love that idea with the big machine.
Yeah.
Just, like, compressing and things and melting down everything.
And you can just
everything.
Feel the heaviness that...
The depth of everything, and just the dust. There was so much detail, and just all the objects they had, like every, like thousands of little pieces of just crap everywhere that would just like fall down when you saw the fire breathers moving all the garbage all around, and you would just see everything fall and you have the dust in front of that. It was just so much animation. And I know people take that for granted, like we're just used to watching, you know, certain things.
And
it's just amazing. A lot of work went into this, and a lot of work goes into Clone Wars no matter what. But when you have a lot of details like that, and to have the depth of it all with the fire blazing, and you have like all these blacks and reds and oranges and, you know, all these molecules just all over the, it's just cool. And you have the machines dropping crap all over, I keep saying crap, but like garbage everywhere. Pretty impressive. I liked it.
Yeah.
And they must live on like melted metal.
Yeah.
Because they were just putting it in their mouths and just, you know.
Oh, yeah.
So I wonder who operates those machines. But then again, they're probably just droids, you know, like little creatures.
That's
you
right,
never know. You know, like we just assume because that's what we do. And we are very open-minded, though. I'm just saying, like, it's normal human nature to assume certain things. And you can have all kinds of creatures. So maybe little people or something we don't understand. Machines them, or are they just machine themselves, like other droids, like they're smart. And I think that would be the better route to go, because how do you really live there? Like, oh, okay, this is a great job, guys. Take your lunch break. I wouldn't go anywhere. So I can't wait to watch the next episode. I know that we're kind of spoiled because we saw the two thumbnails for today and the next time, which this time had Savage, next time has Darth Maul, so we knew he was going to find him, whether in this one or the next one. So I'm glad we're back on this arc or a new arc with them, because it feels like it's been so long ago that, well, we saw Savage and then he went on this mission. So interesting. Can't wait for more, guys.
Yeah.
That's right. And everyone can feel his force. Darth Maul's force. So.
Ooh, that's
right.
Yeah.
Even Dooku.
I love the idea of the force. Dooku.
Yes.
So much debate and so much like discussion there. It's so great. So thank you guys so much for watching. Please subscribe. We love you guys watching our stuff, and any help you can give us on Patreon really helps us grow so we can make more content. So we'll see you very soon as always. Thanks guys. Bye.
Thanks. Bye. Subscribe.